I'm Hannah. I'm a senior designer at MRM Global. I work with some of the world's largest drink brands. So I work with Bacardi, Diageo, Pernod Ricard, Molson Coors, those kind of things. And we work with creating alcohol brand menus, point of sale items. So I receive hundreds of briefs daily from loads of different places all around the world. Some of them are in Spanish, Italian, and it's all about making sure that you pull the right information through to get what you need from the brief. So first of all, when I receive a brief, I'll have a look into who sent me the brief and what type of thing they'd be looking for. In my case, it would be a bar. I would probably have a look at the bar's social media, their website, do a wee bit of research into what types of things they've done in the past, have a look at their fonts, their colours, the pictures. Sometimes a lot of I kind of take inspiration from their interior, so maybe a visit to the bar to have a look at the, you know, how they've designed it. And those types of things influence the way that the design moves forward. From this point, you can either create a mood board. I do a lot of my researching on Pinterest, Instagram, things like that, to gather kind of resources. Pin all my kind of colours together, fonts together, and types of images in the direction that I want the design to go in. And you can send it back to the client for approval, or you can continue the process. There's two types of briefs that you can get. One type of brief you have is very picky. They will have exactly what they want in their mind and they expect you to mind read. So you will literally have to try and be empathetic and understand what they want from the client's perspective, but also use your own initiative as well. Feel free to argue your design, not in a bad way, but push forward why you've used certain things and support yourself and make sure that you're telling the client why you've chosen to do things, and 9 times out of 10 they will understand. You will then get another brief which they give you nothing, they tell you to use your own initiative. These briefs can just be as challenging as the creative briefs where they've been very specific. You have to use you have nothing to kind of go with, so you have to create your own thing. So again, look at the bar's name, take inspiration from names, colours, fonts, everything that's kind of surrounding that bar creatively, and then you can kind of draw your inspiration from there. A lot of the time these clients can be just as challenging as each other. In one aspect, your picky client will know exactly what they want and you have to understand exactly what they want. With your non-creative client who's given you nothing to work with, they will also have an idea of what they want in their mind, they just don't quite know how to articulate it. So it's very important as a designer to be really empathetic and understand the client, their needs, and what type of thing they'd be looking for. Another thing to look into is who's going to be attending the bar, or what the demographic of the company is, whether it's young people, old people. These kind of things take into consideration the design quite a lot. So you'll then change the colours, your kind of fonts, images, all depending on what your demographic is. So it's really important to take that into consideration as well.